Self-esteem is the way in which a person views his or herself. A person with a healthy self-esteem has a positive outlook and believes in himself. A person who is lacking demonstrates anger and negativity. In fact, many people have written about the symptoms of lack of self-esteem. Two of these people are Jillian Butler and Tony Hope, authors of Managing Your Mind, who listed the signs of low self-esteem as follows: feelings of being unloved, overly dependent, inability to make decisions, extreme jealousy, excessive worry, fear of trying new activities, risk-taking, perfectionism, inability to describe or even understand feelings, frustration, excessive anger, need to overachieve, poor school performance, highly critical of self and others, continuously in poor health, poor posture, slumping, inability to look people in the eye, drug, alcohol abuse, sexual promiscuity, eating disorders, self-mutilation. While it is important to develop self-esteem in childhood, since a person is very impressionable from the ages 1 to 5, self-esteem can be developed at any time or age. One just has to be patient and persevering. There are many ways to develop self-esteem. There are various reading materials on this subject. One of the most famous is Chicken Soup for the Soul by Jack Canfield. Incidentally, he also conducts self-esteem seminars. Self-esteem seminars could take anywhere from 1 to 3 days, and these are wonderful tools to help develop self-esteem. One can also opt to seek therapy. The key to developing self-esteem is first to recognize what you lack. Pinpoint areas that made you that way and let go. Only with letting go can the process of healing and moving on can truly begin. Most societal problems today are born out of a lack in self-esteem. While the most successful people first believed in themselves. Developing self-esteem can be a daunting task, but with the right tools and determination, anyone of any age can become better individuals. It would probably surprise a lot of people how a healthy self-esteem could turn their lives around and provide for them success in whatever they choose to do. Self-assessment tests are available on the net, but for a thorough evaluation it would be best to seek professional help. Tests on the net usually just give glimpses or ideas of one's personality strengths and weaknesses. On the other hand, it also lists some self-esteem seminars that one can opt to attend. Some popular seminars include Jack Canfield, author Chicken Soup for the Soul, Self-Esteem Optimization Seminar, www.optimalthinking.com/self-esteem, National Association for Self-Esteem, NASE, Self-Hell Energy Workshop, Dr. Doris Jeanette, while other reading materials include Measures of Self-Esteem. Blaskovich, Jim and Joseph Tomarka, Measures of Personality and Social Psychological Attitudes, J.P. Robinson, P.R. Shaver, and L.S. Reitzman, Two Dimensions of Self-Esteem, Reciprocal Effects of Positive Self-Worth and Self-Deprecation on Adolescent Problems. Owens, Timothy J., Accentuate the Positive and the Negative, Rethinking the Use of Self-Esteem, Self-Deprecation, and Self-Confidence. Owens, Timothy J., Extending Self-Esteem Theory and Research, Owens, Timothy J., Society and the Adolescent Self-Image, Rosenberg, Morris, Conceiving the Self, Rosenberg, Morris, Self-Esteem, Clinical Assessment and Measurement Validation. Silber, E. and Tippett, Jean, Self-Esteem, Its Conceptualization and Measurement, Wells, L. Edward and Gerald Marwell, The Self-Concept, Wiley, Ruth C. Indeed, it is truly important to develop self-esteem, and in this day and age, this can easily be done. If you have the financial means, then you might want to consider taking seminars. However, you can also learn through books, and there are various publications. The possibility is just endless, and besides, it is never too late to be a better person. How self-esteem workshops and seminars can help you. Self-esteem basically deals with how a person thinks about his or her own self. It is the mental self-image that we have of ourselves, and can play a huge part in your success or failure, as may be the case. A person with good self-esteem thinks positively about himself, while the person with a low self-opinion is flooded with negative emotions. Jillian Butler and Tony Hope, through their book titled Managing Your Mind, tell us a lot about the characteristics of low self-esteem. In fact, they give us a list of synonyms that describe low self-esteem. Asterisk, the feeling that no one loves you. Asterisk, too much dependence on others and an inability to make decisions independently. Asterisk, feelings of jealousy. Asterisk, too much worry. Asterisk, too much fear of trying new things in life. Asterisk, trying to be perfect all the time. Asterisk, difficulty in recognizing feelings in the self and in others. Asterisk, feelings of frustration. Asterisk, too much anger. Asterisk, a need to be better than others. Asterisk, poor performances at work or school. Asterisk, too critical of yourself and of others. Asterisk, too much bad health. Asterisk, a poor stance and posture. Asterisk, refraining from looking at people eye to eye. Asterisk, drug and alcohol abuse. Asterisk, bad eating habits. Asterisk, feelings to hurt yourself. It is true that the best time to get a high self-esteem is when you are a child, but that does not mean you cannot help it once you are an adult. When you are a child, you cannot control your surroundings, but when you are an adult, you can do so. You are in control of your life. Attending a self-esteem seminar is one of the best options for adults looking to improve their self-esteem. These seminars normally last from 1 to 3 days and can do a lot for your self-image. When you look at the most successful people in life, you will understand how much a healthy self-esteem can do for you. The reverse is true as well. Most of the problems faced by society today can be traced back to low self-images that people carry of themselves, which can turn them to be destructive towards themselves and to others in the society as well. If you find your own self in such a frame of mind, maybe you should consider attending a good self-help seminar. If you feel you do not have the time or the money to attend such seminars, that shouldn't stop your efforts to improve the self-image. You could always opt for self-help books and articles and e-books on the net. After all, it is you who will benefit from this process, so don't give up easily. Don't give up till you have a healthy self-image and thereby a successful life.